welcome back to the vlog. Today is the 21st of August. I know guys, it has been a really long while since I've vlogged and I'm really sorry about that. But today is not really going to be a vlog because I have told you guys about this Kids with Talent competition a while back, and I told you guys I was gonna vlog, but I ended up not vlogging because I was really nervous that day and I just didn't want to worry about vlogging as well. But now that the competition is over, I kind of want to tell you guys about it and explain how it works and how it went, since my sister did take a video of me performing the one song. Well, actually both, but I'm only going to show you the one song and I'm going to tell you why later. So that's what I'm going to be doing in this vlog. So I'm going to set the camera down somewhere so that I can tell you guys about it. Okay, that should work. Before I start, I just quickly want to say, I know a lot of you guys are only watching this to see the video of me performing, but I do talk a lot in this video, so if you just want to see the video of me performing, skip to like 6 minutes into the video or like 6.5 minutes. I'm not completely sure. It will be in between there, and that is where I will be showing you guys the video. So I want to start from the very beginning because I want to give you guys context onto how music became a part of my life and where it all started, since I haven't really spoken about music that much on my channel before and it's a really big part of my life, so I just want to explain everything to you guys. So it started when I got into high school. There came this guy to our school and he promoted his music school, which the name of the music school is Swallow 15. So when he came to promote his music school, I immediately knew I wanted to be a part of this because my whole life I've loved music and I always wanted to learn to play more instruments and I really wanted to get into music more. So I saw this was my chance, and long story short, I became a part of this music school and that guy is now my music teacher. I get guitar classes with him. He gives me guitar classes as well as with two other students, so we're all in a class and we got very close, and that is also how I became a part of a band. So this music school has a thing called jam bands, and it's basically where they take all of the students that's willing to do it and they form bands, and then the bands perform at whichever venue, which is usually Rumours. So that is how I'm in two bands, and that is a really big part of my life. I love band, I love the music school, it's like my second home. The people there are like my second family, and I'm just really thankful that I got that opportunity, and I wouldn't change it for the world because I love that place so much. Anyway, so I would say that we are very, very lucky to have that guy as our music teacher, because not only is he the owner of the music school, he's also very, very successful and he has a lot of contacts, and basically he can make it happen for us. And not only that, I also look up to him for a lot of different reasons, and he's a big role model in my life, and I think all three of us can agree that we couldn't have asked for a better coach. So moving on, last year at the end of the year, he told us about this competition that he hosts. So it is his competition and it's called Kids with Talent SA, which I'm wearing the shirt right now. And anyways, he told us he wanted us to participate in it, me and my two friends, and obviously we were really excited for it. We wanted to do it, it's experience and it's also really fun, so all three of us really wanted to do it. And then at the beginning of this year, we all received a list of songs that we could choose from to like perform at the competition. By the way, all three of us entered in the guitar category, so we played guitar. There's also vocals and piano and open category and so on, but we entered for the guitar category. So this competition also has two sections, the experience and the actual competition. The experience is for all of the kids that doesn't really have a lot of experience and they first want to see how they are on stage, if they have stage fright, just like get a little bit of experience before they go into the competition, because this is also one of the biggest music slash talent competitions in South Africa for kids. We decided we wanted to sign up for the experience as well because we don't have a lot of experience on stage and we also first wanted to see how it would go. So we did the experience, and that was like a few months back, so it was a while ago, and it went really well and I was super excited for the actual competitions. But then I broke my arm. As you guys know, I do have a video on my main channel which you can go check out to find out how it happened. It will be linked down below. Anyway, so I broke my arm and I thought I wouldn't be able to do the competition, and it was really sad. But then when I got to guitar practice the next week, I realized I can still play the songs and I can still play guitar, which is really crazy. You guys are gonna see on the video. And not only that, my guitar coach also told me that it would be really cool if a girl with a broken arm plays guitar against other boys playing guitar at a competition. So the day of the competition came and I was super nervous, but I think everybody was. And the venue, it was a really nice venue. The stage was big, but it wasn't very big, but it was bigger than the stage we had at the experience. So we first had to sound check our two songs. My two songs was Pour Some Sugar on Me and Final Countdown, by the way. So I did really rock and roll songs with my broken arm, and I'm a girl, which it's kind of cool. But I struggled a lot with Pour Some Sugar on Me. Final Countdown was the best song of the two, so I decided to do Final Countdown last because it's like my final impression that I have on the judges. But then when the show started, our coach, which was also the MC of that show that night, he said that everybody has two songs and only the best one of the two counts. And that was such a relief because I knew I would mess up in Pour Some Sugar On Me because it's just a lot of notes that you have to hit and oh. So that was such a relief, and then I performed Pour Some Sugar On Me and I messed up a lot, guys. I messed up so badly, and the thing about it is I practiced it so much the night before, and when I practiced it in my room I didn't mess it up at all. I was really confident in the song, and then I messed it up really bad that night, so I'm not gonna show you the video. But then there was a break and then everybody had to do their second performance, and I knew I had to give it all or nothing for Final Countdown because this was my final chance and it's gonna be the last impression on the judges, so I knew I had to give it my best. So I had a quick outfit change, not really. I just put on another shirt and it went really well. Here's the video.
It is Leanne on the guitar.
On me, not only because my parents invited the whole family and they saw how I messed up in my first song, so I really had to impress them this time, but it was also the last impression on the judges. So if I messed this song up, I knew I wouldn't have a chance to go to finals. By the way, this competition was regionals, and if we go through to finals, then it's finals and then you see who actually wins. So then there was awards at the end of the night and I came second in the guitar category, which I'm still really proud of that. There's still a chance that I can go to finals. And then one of my friends that has guitar class with me, he came third. And then another guy came first, but he was really good. And my other friend that has guitar class with us didn't place. And I feel really sorry for him because he was really good. And I think it was really close between the three of us. And our coach did tell us we should go on different nights just so that we can shine more on stage. But yeah, I guess everything happens for a reason, and now we're gonna hear this week if we are through to finals, and I'm just super excited. And that's basically how it went and the story behind it, and I'll let you guys know if I'm through for finals. If I am through to go to finals, I will definitely, I think, vlog that day because I want to bring you guys with me on the experience and show you guys kind of like the behind the scenes. So yeah. So that was it for this vlog. I know it wasn't really a vlog, but if you enjoyed it, give it a big thumbs up. And if you want to see any of my future vlogs, make sure to subscribe to my vlog channel as well as my main channel. There will be two circles over here that you can click on to subscribe. And I'll see you guys in the next video.